Hey guys, this is Nehal, and once more you are most welcome to my channel at Crazy for Veggie. Now hold on my viewers who has a sweet tooth, because today I will going to make no bake white chocolate peach mousse cake. Please shower your love by liking this recipe, and also please take a time to like my Facebook page, which I'm going to mention link in the description box. If you do enjoy this dessert by heart as much as I enjoy this too. So now let's start to work with our first layer of the graham crackers. So here I'm using this honey graham crackers. Now you can use any graham crackers you like, but especially, you know, I like the crust of these crackers in my dessert because of its mild sweetness of the honey, and I don't have to add the sugar. But if you can't find these crackers nearby your grocery store, you can also certainly use the marigold biscuit. Try to add, you know, couple of tablespoons of the sugar. So now grind these crackers and make a fine powder out of it, and then pour a melted butter on a top of it, and now simply mix it well. Now take a 8-inch springform cake tin and simply, you know, layer this. Now try to create an even surface when you are pretty much satisfied by your work of perfection. You can use the fingers though, that's up to you. Now let it rest in the refrigerator until we're done working in our second layer, or minimum of 15 minutes. Now let's start to work on our white chocolate mousse. So take one glass bowl and add a white chocolate and heavy whipping cream to it. Now place this bowl on a double boiler. Let wait until steam start to work hard. And as you can see, because of the heat of a water steam, our chocolate is melting. So switch off the flame once you notice chocolate is completely melted, and place it aside. Now let's start to work on a heavy cream. So bring in a bowl, and I am going to add 2 cups of heavy whipping cream into it. 1 cup each for white chocolate and a peach layer. But if you wish, you can churn it separately, you know, 1 cup each, so it will be easy to divide. But I can definitely eyeball, and I'm good at that. So churn it with a hand blender on a high until it reaches stiff peaks. You can see if your cream is holding strong and not dripping down, they are ready to move forward. So this is also done. So let's now work on a agar agar part. So this is a agar agar powder. It is also called happy grass, which is vegetarian substitute of a gelatin. Now all the agar agar powders are, you know, playing the different roles. If I'm saying I'm going to use the 2 teaspoon, believe me, if I'm using the another brand, I might ended up, you know, using more or less. So please play around and know your agar agar. I personally face this problem, but once you know your agar agar powder, you know that how much you have to add. So now add agar agar to the bowl, and then add water to it and start mixing it until you can see that agar agar is almost, you know, melted into the water. Now let this boil on a stove until you can see that agar agar is completely dissolved. Now this is my melted white chocolate, which is on a room temperature right now. So make sure it is on a room temperature, not hot, not warm. So add this hot agar agar water into that and mix it well. Now take half of the whipped cream in another bowl, just, you know, eyeball it, and add this chocolate mixture into it. Now mix it with your spoon or using the hand blender, anyway you are comfortable. Just mix it all together, and here we are with a beautiful creamy white chocolate cream. So pour this mixture into our cake pan. Just try to even the surface. You can give a 1 or 2 tap, so it will, you know, relieve the air bubbles inside, and even the surface. And now let it pop in the refrigerator until we work on our last layer of a peach. So here I have my peaches. I am using the peach with the juice here. I have the canned one. So I am going to add this peaches to my blender jar, and I'm going to add about like couple of tablespoon of its juice into it, and you just simply have to make the puree out of it. Isn't it that simple? Just take it out into one bowl. Now I want my cake to pop with a beautiful orange color, so I'm adding some of the food color. But if you don't want, you can always skip this step. Now add sugar to it and again mix it well by spoon, by hand blender, blah blah blah. So here is the hot water of the agar agar, which I made exactly the same way as I made for the white chocolate part. Now mix it well and pour the peach puree to our already churned cream, which we already used half of it. Mix it well by spoon, by hand blender, and yay! We are done with our third layer too. Now it's time to pour, because our second layer is already set. At least, you know, it is about a half an hour right now. So yeah, make sure you wait until that. So layer it on a top of a white chocolate layer. Look at it. It's looking damn tempting. I can't even wait for all those resting hours. Those are the annoying ones, seriously. Anyway, so again, even the surface, try to tap again and, you know, let all the air bubble out of it and let it rest in the refrigerator for around like 8 to 10 hours or overnight to set our cake. And here we are. Da-da-da. Our cake is ready. Simply run the knife to the edge to separate the cake from the cake tin and open the tin. Oh my God, look at the amazing piece of heaven. Decorate it with some leftover peach, some mint leaves, or anything you like to pop on it. It's looking super creamy, rich in flavors. Simply mind-blowing. Do try decorate some Halloween stuff for this Halloween season and rock yourself in a party. I bet you will be the person of attention. So yeah, that's it for my today's session. I hope you guys like this no-bake white chocolate peach mousse cake. If you do like, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will see you soon in my next session. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.